Hello students, let us discuss the next part of the lesson, National Movement, the Early Phase, 1885-1918. So in the previous class we discussed about the first phase. Then let us discuss extremist phase, 1905-1920. What is the meaning of extremist phase? So violent in political matters. So in the previous leaders, means the moderate leaders, fought against the Britishers with peace. So only they submitted petitions to the government, and they conducted processions in the streets like that. They never fought harshly against the Britishers. But in the leaders of Swadeshi movement, with the start of the Swadeshi movement around 1903, the Indian national movement took a major leap forward. Women, students and large sections of the urban and rural population of Bengal and other parts of India became actively involved in politics from the first time. So at the time of Swadeshi movement, what is the meaning of Swadeshi movement? So use the goods which are produced in the India only. So you have to, they boycotted the foreign goods. That is the meaning of Swadeshi movement. In that movement, all category people, even students, women and other people also participated actively in this movement. One major trigger for this movement was the proposal for the partition of Bengal into East and West Bengal in 1903 by Curzon. So why this movement was started? Because of the Britisher decided to divide the Bengal into two parts, East Bengal and West Bengal, in 1903. So immediately revolt started against this . Ordinary people of Bengal were engaged by this act and took enraged by this act and took to streets to protest against it. There were massive protests, petitions and campaigns, but they were not heeded to, and the government partitioned Bengal in 1905. So against the decision, people did so many hastations, even though the Bengal was partitioned in 1905. So several protest meetings were held, and together they decided to boycott English cloth and salt. That is called Swadeshi movement. So there was a tremendous mass response got for this. They boycotted public burnings of foreign clothes, picketing of shops selling foreign goods became common in remote corners of Bengal as well as in many important towns and cities throughout the country. So in the Swadeshi movement, what they did? They boycott and public burning of foreign cloth. So they sat in front of the shops where the foreign goods are selling. Okay, so these are very common, not only the urban areas, in rural areas also they did. Women refused to wear foreign bangles and use foreign utensils. Washermen refused to wash foreign clothes, and even priests in temples declined offering which contained foreign sugar. So that much tremendous response came from the public. So the spontaneous unity of diverse social groups was the basis of Indian nationalism. Okay, so the early nationalists were successful in germinating the nationalism. So who are the early nationalists? The moderate leaders were succeeded in germinating this nationalism. Next, there was also a call for boycott of all government institutions at the same time, like schools, colleges, courts, etc. People set up their own schools, own courts, okay, and colleges and parallelly, okay, so courts in which they settled their mutual disputes. The idea was to refuse to cooperate with the government in this way and determine its position. The Swadeshi movement gave tremendous movement to the Indian history. Why? Because all people decided to use only goods which are used in, which are produced in India. So that's why Indian industries became popular. In fact, beginning were made in the manufacture of Swadeshi salt, sugar, matches and other products on a large scale. The movement gave a stimulus to P.C. Roy's Bengal Chemical Works and encouraged Jamshedji Tata of Bombay to open his famous steel plant in Bihar. By this movement only, these people started industries in our country. The movement also created tremendous demand for native goods. So all are decided to use the Indian goods only. The textile industry of India in particular received a great momentum from the Swadeshi movement. Like that, those industries were became developed. The moderate and the extremist. So in the next Congress session, 1905, the extremist nationalists, already we discussed, extremist means violent in political matters. Who are violent in political matters? Those are called extremists. Nationalists led by Tilak, Bipin Chandra Pal and Lala Lajpat Rai were in favor of extending the movement to the rest of India and to demand for full-fledged freedom or Swaraj. So by seeing the tremendous response from the public, so these extremist leaders like Tilak, Bipin Chandra Pal and Lala Lajpat Rai decided to extend this movement to throughout the country to demand for full-fledged freedom or Swaraj. So Bala Gangadhar Tilak gave the famous slogan, "Swaraj is my birthright and I shall have it." Swaraj is my birthright and I shall have it. That slogan was given by Bal Gangadhar Tilak. So they wanted to move away from the earlier strategy of submitting petitions to government to the new strategy of mobilizing the masses against the British rule and forcing the British to give up and go. So previously all the leaders, moderate leaders, hesitated peacefully. But these leaders, at present leaders, don't want to follow that path. They want to force the Britishers to leave the India. They called the earlier strategy as mendicancy or begging for alms. The old leaders called moderate nationalists wanted to continue on a more gradual piece of movement and felt that the massive were not yet ready for a full-scale movement for freedom and self-rule. So the moderate leaders argued that this is the time for full fight against the Britishers. So some differences came between two group of leaders, between extremist leaders and moderate leaders. So because of that, Congress also split into two groups in Surat session of 1907. So the extremist leaders like Tilak were forced to leave the Congress. They came out from the Congress. So because of this movement, so the British government reacted very aggressively. So most of the leaders like Tilak were imprisoned and exiled. Exiled means they sent out of the country, like other countries, to prison. Gradually the movement petered out, slowly became calmed down. Many young Swarajis felt let down by these developments and began to turn to terrorist attacks on unpopular British officials like Bhagat Singh, Veera Savarkar. So like that, these extremist leaders began to turn to terrorist attacks on unpopular British officials, even though they did not succeeded anywhere. So they were caught and hanged or imprisoned. They kept alive the spirit of nationalism and the idea of making supreme sacrifices for it. Okay, so because of that, we are remembering now also. The national movement revived again in 1915 when Tilak came back from his exile and joined hands with Annie Besant to launch a movement for home rule. What is the meaning of home rule? So here they want to, the Indian leaders want to rule themselves. Okay, so the two, between 2016-2018, the home rule was started. The two factions of the Congress united again in 1916 through the Lucknow Pact. So the First World War, 1914-1918. So before independence, we faced two world wars, First World War and Second World War. So in the First World War was started in 1914. So the First World War broke out in 1914 with Britain, France and Russia on one side and Germany and allies. Allies means friends, group of countries. Germany and its allies on the other side. So World War was started between two groups. In one group, Britain, France and Russia and other countries, and another side, Germany and its allies on the other side. So it lasted for continued for nearly 5 years till Germany was finally defeated. In the First World War, Germany was defeated. So this caused unprecedented human suffering and destruction. So many were died in that World War. So remaining people also suffered. As the war ended, an era of revolution started in Europe. So after the First World War, so many revolutions started in Europe, especially in Russia. A socialist revolution took place in Russia, in which peasant workers and soldiers led by communists deposed the emperor, dethroned the emperors, and abolished landlordism and private ownership of land and factories. So they also encouraged all nations to get the freedom. So in India also, the war brought great suffering for the common people, as the British tried to raise funds and resources for the war by raising taxes. They imposed more taxes on people of India, and they exported food and other necessities to the armies at the time of First World War. So it is raised the discontent in the people. So this increased the discontent among the people against the British rule. As the news of the Russian Revolution spread, it too inspired people of other countries. Everyone expected so that the British would accept the just demands for democratic rule in India and bring in the constitutional reforms. So, however, this was not to be, and the British introduced harsher laws in our country. It was under these conditions when the discontent of the people was increasing and the British were getting more repressive. So at the same time, Mahatma Gandhi came back to India from South Africa and joined in the national movement. So like that, second phase of national movement started. Okay, so on the day of the partition of Bengal, so on 16th October 1905, so the Britishers divided the Bengal into two parts. So throughout the Bengal, in the next day, throughout the Bengal, no cooking was done and shops and markets were closed. In Calcutta, a hartal was declared. Hartal was declared. People took out possessions and bathed in the Gangas in the morning and then paraded on the streets singing Vande Mataram. So people tied rakhis on each other's hands as a symbol of unity of the two halves of Bengal. So later in the day, Ananda Mohan Bose and Surendranath Banerjee addressed two mass meetings attended by about 70,000 people. So after the partition of Bengal, so people came out from the houses and started hesitations against that partition. Next, Krishna Patrika of Machilipatnam. Krishna Patrika was started in Machilipatnam in 1909-1902. Mutnuri Krishna Rao was one of the founders of the paper, and since 1902 he was associated with it as its sub-editor. In 1907 he became the editor of the Krishna Patrika and continued to serve the journal till he died in 1945. The Krishna Patrika carried on its publicity to the movements which are held in the India. So for all the phases of India's struggle for freedom, like the Vande Mataram movement, the Home Rule movement, the non-cooperation movement, the civil disobedience movement, and the Quit India movement. At the time of all these movements, so Krishna Patrika given more publicity for these movements. The Krishna Patrika influenced not only the urban educated elite, but also the rural masses. So not only magazine, both the magazine and the editor showed their extreme anger on British rulers several times. So like that, all are participated in the second phase of the national movement. Clear? So with this, lesson is completed. So write your own notes. Thank you.